स्टार्ट द प्रेयर ओम समस्त जन कल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमोमि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्म विद्वरं वसुदेव सुतं देवं कंसचानूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानंदं कृष्णं वंदे जगद्गुरुं त्वमेव माता च पितात्वमेव त्वमेव बन्धुश्च सखात्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्रविडं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव त्वमेव सर्वं गुरुदेव देव हरि ओम वी आर डूइंग द क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स ऑन वेदांत वन ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस एंड इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग दैट टू नो इज व्हाट आर दिस अन्वय व्यतिरेक लॉजिक दिस हैज बीन यूज्ड इन ऑर्डर टू अराइव एट द ट्रूथ So what is Anvaya and what is Vyatireka and how is this logic is applied? We'll give just brief account of this. Anvaya means if there are two things, one is, the other is. If there are two dependent things, one is, the other is. And that's called Anvaya. And Vyatireka is, one is not there and other is also not there. So that means both are either appearing together or disappearing together. Anvaya means appearing together, Vyatireka means disappearing together. That means they must be intimately related to each other and one becomes a cause and one may be effect and both are appearing and both are disappearing. This is what is called Anvaya Vyatireka. Now how do we apply this? For example, let's say that there are two things. One is the ring is and the gold is. Because they are related, one is a cause and one is an effect. So the cause and the effect, this is called material cause. So gold is and the ring is, and that is called one is, the other is. This is called Anvaya. So Anvaya is applicable. And now if you say that the Vyatireka and gold is not there, therefore is a ring there? There cannot be a ring without a gold. So ring is also not there. So we have a case where from the gold point, this is not there, that's also not there. So both are dependent on each other and one is, the other is. One is not there, other is not there. This is from the gold point. Look at from the ring point. Ring point is, ring is, gold is. So wherever there is a ring, there is a gold because we are talking about golden rings only. So we say, hey, bring that gold. What gold? That ring, that is the gold only. So when I bring the ring, I am bringing the gold only, and the cost of the ring depends upon gold only, how much gold it has. So essence of that ring is only gold. So that is the essential knowledge. So ring is, gold is. That is called Anvaya. Now we go to Vyatireka. Ring is not there, but gold still is. So this Vyatireka doesn't work in this way, because even though the ring is, suppose I destroy the ring and make a bangle out of it. So ring is no more there, but gold is still there. So gold is conserved, but ring is not conserved. So ring is only name and a form for a gold. So Vyatireka doesn't work only because the gold is more fundamental compared to ring. So this, we use the Anvaya Vyatireka in both ways, from the point of cause and see if the effect is there. Cause is there, effect will be there. If cause is not there, effect will not be there. From the point of effect, effect is there, cause is there. Effect is not there, cause is still there. And we use that in order to solve who is the Brahman or who am I. And we cannot say Brahman is, the world is. And Brahman is not there, you cannot say Brahman is not there, Brahman is ever existent. And then, suppose we say world is not there, is Brahman there? From the world point, world is there, Brahman is there. But world is not there, then what happens? So how do you know world is not there? That we experience in the deep sleep state every day. Every day, the waking world is gone, dream world has come. Dream world has gone, deep sleep state where there is no world of anything. What is there? That which is source of everything, cause is still there. But who is the cause? I don't know. I don't know because all I know is I am there. How do I know I am there? Because I say I slept very well. So, it is essentially the cause-effect relation pointing out something which is strange, because the world is there, I am there. World is not there, still I am there. This Anvaya, this Vyatireka points out that I am beyond the world too. That's why I am there, no space, no time, no Einstein, nobody. Because all those relationships of subject-object duality is not there, but I am there. But I don't know that. How do I know? How would I know? So you cannot know who that I am is veiled in the deep sleep state, because to know, mind is required. But when mind is there, everything else is coming in too. So I had to develop a technique to know who is that I am with the mind, with all other things absent, but still concentrate on that. That's what we use Anvaya Vyatireka logic to arrive at cognitively who is that I am. Let's look at from the point of gold back again. Now there are two causes there. One is the material cause, another is the intelligent cause. So material cause is the gold, intelligent cause is the goldsmith. He is the one who made the gold. Now look at from the point of that cause, intelligent cause. So goldsmith is there, the ring is there, a bangle is there, it may be there, it may not be there. It may be in his idea, in his mind, or he may have sold it somewhere else. So the intelligent cause is there, the product may not be there. And if the product is there, the ring is there a goldsmith? Goldsmith may not be there, but goldsmith has to be there one time or other in order to create the ring. Ring doesn't come just like that. So it is an intelligent creation and not randomly coming in. So by looking at the product cause, the effect, we have to infer there must be an intelligent cause who made it. And that's exactly what we need to do when we look at the whole universe. The beautiful creation is there. The flowers are blooming, insects are crawling, and every life form is pulsating, and the whole world is, Jagat itself is enchanting and so enormous, and there must be an order in the universe. It's not just randomly coming in. So because a scientist sitting in a corner of a earth can deduce the laws, galaxies and galaxies away, which means it's an ordered system. Ordering involves work. Work has to be done for any order, and who created that order, that we bring in Ishvara. We don't see him, but we have to cognitively say it cannot be ordered creation without a proper intelligent cause. So here we don't see the cause, the intelligent cause, but we have to deduce that where is that Ishvara. Scripture says everything by Ishvara himself. So what I am seeing is actually Ishvara in different forms. That forms is both the material cause and intelligent cause in this case. And that's what is the universe of creation itself. With that we stop now. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ओम शांति शांति शांति. हरि ओम श्री